Hello, is anyone alive out there? Can anybody hear me? It's your boy Davo, and I am back for another segment of Dishin with Davo. However, if you're wondering why the kitchen looks a little different this time, it's because I'm not alone, and I'm not at home, and that rhymes. But I'm here once again with not just the best, but the bestest. Lady J, come on down. Woo, woo.
Drop it.
Right now, we are in the kitchen of Miss Lady J here, the bestest. Give it up for her, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, thank you. It's a pleasure.
All right, and so tonight we're changing the name of Dishing with Davo because it's not just Davo, it's just Dishing with Jasmine and Davo.
Yes.
Let's get it. Let's get it. All right, Jess. You're a Mexican girl, right?
Yeah.
A food. Yeah. You're black. But
no,
you like to get into
it.
The Mexican.
I love
you like to get
some
the Mexican.
Mexican food.
So what are we cooking tonight?
Mexican.
Fill me up. Are we getting a little?
We're gonna get a little bit of a taco.
Oh.
Salt and hot.
Oh.
Yes. And nachos.
Oh.
And guac, homemade
from the man.
Yes,
we not using y'all recipes online.
No, it's about palate.
That's right, season to taste. Mm-hmm. What we want. And if it comes out nasty,
that's not an option.
Well, they won't know because we'll just
say it's good.
That's right.
That's
yep. All right, so Jew, given the honors of everything that we have here, what's our ingredients? What type of tacos? What type of nachos are we making for the
steak?
People?
And chicken. That's the meat. Because let me tell you, like, you know, with Mexican food, you can do a little this on here, a little that on there. So we can have chicken taco, steak, nacho, we can mix and match, whatever combo.
That's right.
Yes. David's going to go with the spicy. I got the, what are the jalapenos?
And
five of them.
We're not going to use all of them. They was like 99 cents for a pound. So I just grabbed
a bunch of,
and they still wasn't a pound. So I did less than a dollar. But two, I know how y'all people who tight about your little Mexican food is. We're having steak, not carne asada.
Okay.
We're not doing that.
No.
We're not. And Chipotle, I want you to take that off the menu because I don't like it. It's too limey. You know I love Chipotle. You know.
I've never had it.
Don't do it. I mean, you can ask for a sample. I asked for a sample, which I didn't know you could do that, but you can ask for a sample.
Me either. How many samples you get?
They gave me about two pieces. Uh-huh. It's real limey.
Well, I mean, could I say, I want sample chicken, and I want sample steak. Let me get a little sample.
The same Baskin Robbins, you can't sample.
Okay.
You know what? I think they put a limit on me. I could have sworn they stopped me at 3.
31.
It was either them. It might have been Costco. Or it might have been like it's Panda Express. Panda Express, you can't remember. I was filled up off the samples alert. Okay.
Oh my goodness.
All right. So we got our chicken steak, tacos, nachos. We got that going on.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. But what are we gonna dish about?
You already know. We in the A.
We in the A.
So, I mean, we gotta talk about
the women of the A. The hottest women on reality TV.
Real Housewives of Atlanta.
This is our show.
Yes.
But we have made a pact to not discuss this show.
And it has been hard.
I've been trying to tell her what I want to say about these houses. She wouldn't let me.
I'm not to get it all out tonight.
I'm getting it out tonight because there's a lot to say. And we're only mid-season.
I know because they dropped the mid-season trailer.
And we're going to get into that mid-season trailer.
Both of them. Because the one they showed last night on
they
TV.
Played you if you only watched it on TV.
It's
you got to go online. It's longer and juicier.
Yes, it is.
All right, well, I guess before we get things started, let's get some drinks going.
Oh, I'm all about it.
So the plan here was, I do love Twizzlers, but I was also like, oh, we need something to know whose drink is who. But then when you pulled out the glasses, it's going to be kind of obvious who's drink. But
you just like this glass.
I love it. And you racial profiling. You are prejudiced against that glass.
I bought
this glass last night and she
I don't like that glass. No, it's for me. Mm-hmm. Just for you.
I might as well just do two different wines today. You'll be drinking Menage a Trois, Pinot Noir. And I'm doing Menage a Trois, Soft Red Blend. And no, or yes, this is the only menage we do. And Nicki, I do Nicki Minaj.
You can have a...
Excuse us, y'all, if I have to cut this camera off. You're not gonna do this.
Ain't even poured a drink yet.
Ain't even. We supposed to get into things about the Housewives. Don't bring up Nicki.
Well, I was just making the letting the people know there will not be a fight over that.
Oh!
You started without me, huh?
I might have to get into some of yours later.
Look at there, look at there.
I'm a man, I'm a king. We need more. You know.
Give me no. Give me
oh, wait. Yeah, you need. Get it. All right. I put it in a recycling bin, America.
Ooh, oh, see the click? That's it with the other bottles that's in there. Oh, that don't sound good.
They already saw what you did to that Ciroc bottle. Be fancy. We gotta do a whoosh, whoosh.
Whoosh, whoosh.
Pinky up. Pinky chip. Oh, okay.
Waiting all day.
Who told y'all don't drink red wine out of straw? It ain't a straw, it's a Twizzler. It ain't really coming out too good. Just gonna use that as a stirrer. All right.
Next.
Let's get into it. You know, before we really get cooking and wiping things up, we wanna show America that we are clean.
Okay.
And we're gonna wash these
hands.
And we're gonna try to continue to wash as we touch things and stuff. But at the end of the day, say we missed something, who's eating this food?
We are.
Is they eating it?
No.
So we don't want to hear nothing about wash your hands.
Judge yourself.
Judge your mom. Mm-hmm.
Now you know you can't be talking about people's mom.
Now that's why I say they judge their own mama. Oh, we don't judge. We don't judge anybody.
Say we learned that from another show from the ad. Talking about people's mom.
Don't you want to talk about mama?
All right.
I feel like you was throwing shade to Dr. Heavenly.
No shade, truth. She did talk about which mama.
Everybody's okay. Mama. Everybody's mama, the B word. Oh, Lord, please help Heavenly.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and
eat. All right, let's get this thing started. So tonight, Jasmine will be the chef, and I'm the sous chef, okay? Except for the steak, because she says she don't like to cook steak.
I don't.
And the guac, I guess I gotta take reins on that.
All right,
paper towel. I'm going to go sleep. They're not up. Okay. All right. So,
how do you cook your steak? In the oven? On the stove?
No, on the stove, yeah. Cut it, slice it up.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, the chicken needs to be first. The nachos are appetizer, correct?
Right.
All right.
So, we can do that first. And let me go here, and I'm going to put this on. If you would open, rinse that.
Got you.
That's the beans.
Black beans. Black beans, y'all.
We're going to put them on the stove. Put them on low. We're going to put them in the meat and start
it. All right. Man, no.
Bing.
All right.
Get these stickers off of this veggies.
Put that in the recycling.
You know how crazy how much they charge you for the organic versus the yes. I'm going to just take the stickers off first.
The difference between organic and what they sell you. But yet the ones that what they sell you be the cheap ones, but those would be the big ones. That's when you get more for your bucks, they say, but it ain't the healthy ones. So just watch out, folks. So if you put that together now.
Uh-huh. You gonna blend the veggies?
That too.
Start chopping them up.
But how about we start too?
Oh,
with
oh,
the season.
Okay, all right. I'm following you, Nate.
So now the show started off reintroducing my girl, my baby, the one, the only, Queen Kenya Moore. Kenya Moore, hey, hair care. Whole one man band, that's me. Came in there like Beyonce at Coachella.
Beyonce.
Beyonce. Beyonce. That's her name. saying. No, she already told y'all. People tell her every day she looks like Beyonce.
You know what? I ain't not gonna go in on Kinker. Not right
y'all
now.
Y'all do it, because she ain't nothing but not, the truth. Not y'all right know them light eyes, that long hair look like Beyonce's long weave and her okay, light eyes.
My question is.
What's the question?
The beginning. Go back to, you said they started at the beginning.
They reintroduced my girl Kenya because she took her little year off while she was pregnant with Precious baby.
Oh, that's a precious little baby.
Doll baby. Oh. Doll baby.
Such a precious little baby. She did.
I mean, we got some competition in it, but we're not going to do that.
No.
Because we know baby girl here is a doll. But that's children are not competition.
No. It's right. My boo.
All right.
I said, did you rinse all three?
All three.
All right.
I'm going to rinse these jalapenos while I'm mad.
Okay,
wait,
do you
want to
save anything for just the,
what
do you
want
to do?
For the chicken
and paper?
What do
you
want
to
say? I'm following. I'm
rocking the chicken. Okay.
Rocking the chicken.
Okay, what's
the difference? And just save me like two slivers of each one for the guac.
Oh, right. Okay, so you know what? Let's just go ahead, chop it up, see what we yield.
Okay.
And then we'll do that.
These don't need to be chopped at the end.
I guess I could have waited.
So, they reintroduced her and they showed Portia because, you know, both of them became new mommies.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Was the first episode Brooklyn's doll baby party?
It was something. I think so. It had to be, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let me think. That's so long ago.
I think that was the first episode.
It's
and
not.
It became a thing.
It's just in the beginning of the season.
Oh, beginning of
so
the season. Okay, okay.
All right. But now.
Here you go.
They show her this Kenya, happy as ever, being a mommy for the first time.
Mm-hmm. Finally getting what she always wanted. I just love that.
But they showed a little lacking in something else in Kenya's life.
And what's that?
Her husband.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm going to say this.
Let me hear it.
Because I don't follow too many celebrities on Instagram, but like I said, I love Kenya. She should have been my baby mama, but anyway.
Oh, my goodness.
I followed her.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to see her on live with Mark. Sometimes Mark and the baby.
Mm-hmm.
They was cool as a cucumber, got along. There was a love shown there.
Mm-hmm.
I think they do have that relationship where they both are like witty and like take little jabs at each other, but mm-hmm. it's all in fun and in jest.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like Bravo is taking that and editing it and spinning it.
You
but
think so?
She doesn't help it in her confessionals. But it also is, what is she saying that we're not seeing in the confessionals that they're chopping up? Screw.
So you think that his, because there's somebody who doesn't follow him?
I don't follow him either. I don't even follow social media.
Oh, follow. Oh, would you seen him on her?
On her life. Yeah.
But
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
like some stuff you can't chop. And I know we jump in. I don't know if we going in order. But when it comes to sitting at a table and saying,
oh, you jumping.
I got to, because this ain't no chop. And saying, I don't have no problem with Nene. There is a team. Let me tell you something.
There is definitely,
we is a team.
Hello. Oh.
We not eating that one. No 5 seconds over here. No 5 seconds. They're going to the trade.
Yeah, I'm going to watch.
And now behind closed doors, you might say, I don't have no problem. But when it comes to public, when it comes to the public, you best to say you got a problem.
Gotta have a strong front,
okay,
together.
Or get the quiet. But you will not. You will not.
No, because I'm with you. Because in that scene, Mike had the right stance on it.
Mike did.
Yeah, she's
the right
a nice lady. She ain't did me wrong. But when you hurt my lady.
Mm-hmm. But I think Tar had a better stance. F you and your mom too. That's pretty much what he
did say. But he didn't say that though.
He pretty much
he
said
alluded
it
to.
That he was riding for his book.
Right. But now, the thing with Mark, and like you said, there are things you can't edit.
Yep.
So like the scene when she was FaceTiming him and he was like,
that was
the dog all up in the baby.
I don't like the dogs,
I don't like
in
the
house.
Dog in the house with her. And
which was crazy because everybody remember Velvet, may she rest in peace. And Velvet was Kenya's life.
And Mark came in the picture when Twirl and
Witchcon was just purchased. Twirl and King was just
King
purchased. That thought that was
so you came into her life knowing she had these dolls.
You know, you can't be planning to be this lady's baby daddy and you don't know the children.
Well, that came from another man who you want to talk about.
Oh,
I believe he was locked up.
Okay, well,
he was beating up some other girl.
I googled it.
She got lucky she got out of there quick and early.
Oh my goodness.
Allegedly he beat up somebody. Oh. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
these things. Don't play with us.
They sticking? They bubbling?
No, they good. Okay. They just staying right in.
But yeah, okay,
got
so.
Put some garlic powder on this bed, really?
Yeah, yeah, put some in there. I already put everything on.
You got like a spoon thing or something to lay this on?
No, I broke mine. Yeah, you can use a napkin. Well, here, use this. You ain't chopping nothing.
Yet. Yet. But yeah, so like that type of stuff, when they on FaceTime and stuff, and he just complaining. I think what goes on is, like she said in her confessional, that because he's had kids previously. Mm-hmm. That's onion powder. What go with?
Up in it. Cabinet. It's a big thing.
He thinks he had, like, he tries to tell her.
Behind the tumor. Yeah.
He tries to tell her what to do and how to do it. Like, she can't pick the answer out herself. Or, like, she don't know what's the best interest of her baby.
Well, she would do anything to purposely harm.
Yeah, like, she ain't doing that wrong. So, but I really think in my spirit, he's getting a bad edit from her.
You know what I think? I think Mark is angry.
At what
though? Mark didn't want to be on the show from jump. You know what I mean?
You said he don't want to be?
He didn't.
Yeah, I agree. You know what I mean?
And so it could be, sometimes you're just in a bad mood when you see the camera there. You're like, you know what?
I do, and I think you can see it to make Kenya happy with that.
I already got an attitude about it.
Here's my problem with that, because, man, allegedly, she was punished for that because, you know, she got married off camera and she didn't want to show her husband and stuff like that. How did you punish her, but you let Kim Zolciak go 3 seasons without showing Big Papa at all? We said to this day, unless you did your research, you don't know what Big Papa
They show
like.
Him what they want him? No, they never showed him. Even when she called him in the shoe store and was like, thank you, Big Papa. Or was it the shoe store or a watch store or something like that? She said, thank you, Big Papa. Never showed him.
And then, I mean, even go back to when Kim had her African, all of them had little African princes. She ain't show him either. But she wasn't punished. And I mean,
I don't know.
You know TV side best. So I don't know contracts and stuff, but I don't think I owe you. Although I'm on a reality show, I don't have to give you my entire life.
It could put significant events.
Not good.
You know what I mean? It's all about your contract. Your contract could say some crazy stuff.
Why wasn't she in trouble that season and she got married? Why would it be the next season?
What you mean? She got married during the season?
She got in trouble. She was off the show the next season when she was pregnant. And the marriage already went, because remember, he came on that season at the very end.
Well, I'm saying, did she get married during the season?
She got married off season.
Out of season.
She got married off season, and that's the season when Nene came back and they were cool. They was friends.
And she was already married?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She remember she showed up to Cynthia's house and was like, I'm married now.
Like I said, it could say significant events, and if that's what it says, then that's what it says. So, can't just go around doing what you want to do. You can't sign a contract and decide, well, actually, I think I want to keep this safe. Like, I mean, you know, it's reality TV, so.
She signed up for it. He did.
Right, and when you're married, you become what? One.
And a half.
And a half. One and Little Brooklyn is the half.
Anywho, so she's not the only one who had a little baby in the beginning. We have Portia.
Yes, I love Portia.
Such a sweet little precious baby too. Yes. But another thing was lacking PJ. In her life.
Man.
Honesty. Mm-hmm. Commitment.
Well, he was committed.
To
her. He just was silent. He was committed. He was there. Remember, she was like, I don't even know when you had time to do this. The honesty was lacking.
To keeping the penis trust. In his own pants.
The trust was lacking. I feel so bad for him.
It was.
It's embarrassing. It's embarrassing.
But how shady we get?
You tell me.
I'm just gonna say that. Porsche, I love you, girl. And I just, you know, I don't see what you see, girl.
Let me say.
I don't know what's going on there.
There is a key for every lock.
Oh! Well, his keys was using a couple of locks.
Okay. But I'm just saying, you know.
Which one is on for this? I am so disappointed.
Yeah.
Is it on low?
It's on medium. You can turn it to low.
Which way turns it to?
Up towards the light.
Boom.
No, that's damn. Don't see that line on there.
Oh,
my word.
Drinks are starting early.
Early bottle snacking.
That was.
But the, regardless of if he, even if he had one eye and a hook or hand, she loved that man.
Yes.
And, you know, after, especially after, you know, with us being loyal fans, we've seen it.
You might ask Kudo what's up.
Uh-huh. I think,
wait, go back where you were. Let me see.
You hanging on.
Am I hanging on? Look, let me just rotate the hip. Let me just do it like this. Hey, y'all.
Hey.
But, you know, after seeing everything she went through with her previous husband and that whole heartbreak, it hurts to see Portia going through this again. And to know, you know, like she said, that she has a baby, and like her mama said, I didn't wait this long for her to be my baby mom. That line right there, it's a whole bunch
mama
of
Diane
people out there
about her baby
who
Portia.
Said, who was like, yes, I didn't wait this long.
The camera cut off on us and we had to begin anew from the top. So some footage has been edited so that we didn't repeat ourselves.
So we've already chopped. We already prepped, did a little prep.
Prep, I was gonna say pregame, but that's when you drink. Cause I drink.
Okay.
This guacamole gonna be great though.
Okay, and peel this good old.
She will give me the stinky thing.
I sure am.
Okay.
I sure
am. How do you peel an onion? You just grab it.
Give it here. You cut the guac.
Oh, okay.
Open.
It's an avocado. I know that.
Yeah, well, yeah. Look, I guess you can't just cut it and then it'd be done, right? You gotta add a little something to it.
All right, well, I cut these and you peel the onion, because it's so difficult. Let's get into the season.
Let's do it. Where you wanna start? At the tippy top?
With a knife.
Huh? It's a whole thing right here.
No, and I need a spoon because I take the little dirt out or the seam.
Here.
All right.
Here. You holding the knife wrong? You go over there.
I'm back here.
I need to be near the trash.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna move this up.
You like on the show, our trash. No, I think we like the same people. We just have different opinions about the things they do on the show.
Yes, we do.
So speaking of, I'm just gonna take my cutting board. Speaking of which,
no, you know what? Let's start with the new, because we haven't been able to talk. We took that vow about not talking. I need some stuff. I need to get some stuff off my chest.
Y'all, this is our show, and she made me vow not to talk to her about the show until we was on camera.
Yes.
How dare you do something?
So y'all can get the organic tea.
You know I like to talk, though. Okay. Yeah.
So
organic, like these vegetables should have been. Look how big they are.
Yeah, this, you
this
know,
is a mess.
What happened?
Oh, I did a good job picking these. These are nice, beautiful colors. This is what your avocados should look like. Now, how you should pick them, don't listen to me because I just guessed it. But there is a method to the madness. I know the method to the madness of picking a watermelon.
What is it?
So they said, and we black, so y'all know y'all want the right element. No. So when you first look at a watermelon, you know how watermelon is green, but then like you turn it over, you see like a little like yellow circle thing. Like it's a little lighter on a little
on the top part?
Yeah, on the skin.
Okay.
You want to find one that has a big, like yellowish color going out of it. Because that means it's fully ripe and it's sweeter than that. So you find that with a big little circle that's a little not as green as the rest of the watermelon.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you put it in your hand and you pop it, you should feel a little vibration into your hand that you hold in there. Works for me every time. To look at the cup and then
why can't I just sniff it? You ain't never heard that?
No. Don't do that. Don't.
You ain't gonna sniff it.
So y'all listen to this, and then as we talk about the show, you should know who opinion you should ride for. I'm saying. Says a guy who said, look for the little yellow. Oh. It should look like this. Like this color of the watermelon. The watermelon should look like that little yellow piece.
You still
right there.
It. That means it ain't clear.
I'm just saying.
That means it's not
and
clear.
And then this little piece, you just supposed to like bloop out right like, oop.
That means it's not clear for them.
Okay.
Friend.
See, this got
doing?
Some of the good. We got to put that in it because it has some of the avocado in it.
You
want to
take it out, right?
Yeah, I'm taking it out, but we got, oop, get in there. All right. Now I need to trade. So you want to work out way better. See? It's gonna be hard to work our way back.
Okay,
to
so you're gonna start to talk.
We get through the early stuff quickly.
Uh-oh. That's the trash man.
Who the trash?
That little squeaking noise. Oh. That's trash man coming. That's okay. We get him. You know, all right. We'll just take it out there.
All right. So, the season starts off with reintroducing us to the queen of Real Housewives of Atlanta and queen of Miss USA, not America, Miss Kenya Amora. That's the apartment next door baby in the background.
That's my baby.
That's the,
my baby, her little mouth.
I don't know her. And I'm going to just say this because the people are burning Mark up online. Mm-hmm. Mark is just getting a bad edit, y'all. He's getting a bad edit. Because I've seen him on her live. I've seen them on social media together. And they be laughing, smiling, joking, throwing shade back to him. Like, I think they got that type of jab-jab relationship. Which I like it. What works for you, let it work for you.
Well, can you explain when he was sitting at that table, talking about something he don't have no problem?
You jump.
Because you I don't understand how that could be an edit. This man sat up there and said, no, we on the same team. Mm-hmm.
He said that. And he kind of called her out, talking about something. Well, didn't she apologize? Low key, not do like Kenya. Well, actually, I know. So, she did not apologize to Nene and missed it herself. But Nene has shown the text message that she did reach out with an olive branch. So, I give Nene that. Mm-hmm. She reached out. Mm-hmm. And then she reached out again on Mother's Day. But that the first message was blue. The second one was green. So, you know what that means. Came Mother's Day, Nene was blocked on Kenya's phone.
Yes. I did not know that.
That thing was green. No response neither time from Kenya. So she did reach out, but no, she did not apologize. And Nene says that herself. She did not actually.
The god dang camera cuts off once again. We have no idea what's going on at this point. So we start again.
Jasmine's apartment complex, y'all don't want us to be great.
At all.
First it was top flight. Okay. Security.
And he was just on the job.
Didn't even have a whistle.
Oh, God.
Now it's the... Just keeps cutting off on us, y'all. We done ran through these housewives, and y'all done. I done ate guacamole.
It's delicious. Taste it for the pizza. Delicious. What? Please, what? I get what? From the hiatus.
Show them how it is. Hmm. Show them how it is. Get into it. Delicious. All right. So we about to run. We about to get into the deep part of the show. Okay. Cause the beginning was just easy. Mm-hmm. Sad Kenya, sad Portia, babies, and problems with their men. Mm-hmm. Pray for them. Mm-hmm. Work out.
Cynthia.
Mm-hmm. In love with Mike. Gonna stay in love with Mike. Beautiful. Thirsty Rye Barbie. Wonderful, beautiful. Mm-hmm. The child is fluid.
Next, Candy have the baby.
With a surrogate.
Yep.
Her daughter live in New York and an apartment that none of us can afford.
Great.
Eva, why are you on this show?
Oh, poor Eva.
You have beautiful children.
Congratulations on your beautiful.
Wonderful.
Top model of season 3.
You did your thing, okay. America's
Next
Top Model.
And you know what? And I will say she has grown. She's more polished than she was when she was on that show.
Her braids are gone, so they get longer and longer.
And the camera got us for the last time. Come to find out, was no space left. So we had to use a different recorder.
Eva's braids have gone longer than.
Yes.
You know, you were great on Top Model, but we still just trying to figure out what you're doing on the Housewives. I do appreciate you sticking to your guns with Nene. Well, kind of. She was nice to Nene on that float. But I guess that's being cordial.
One more float.
The float.
New York. But you know she's pregnant.
I guess.
She's pregnant, and I ain't got time to be, you know, and if what went down in the closet really went down in the closet. Hey, girl! Hey! If I'm pregnant, woo! Great to see ya!
Daddy, I don't want to be a mom. Where'd you say the other black couple was? Because they just coming out of that little thing.
Oh, it must be empty. It's all in there. Oh, right here. Because I dumped it in there.
So... You know, I think that's caught us all up. You know, sad to the girls, Portia and Kenya. Mm-hmm. Congratulations, Cynthia and Candy. Engaged, we didn't get to engagement yet. The love and mm-hmm. the baby.
Uh-huh.
And Eva, we still trying to pick you up. Mm-hmm. And to the queen of the Housewives. Oh, excuse me. The one that's called you. She won't be queen. We call the queen. Call the queen.
I would give her those props.
I'll give her the starter of Housewives.
And she knows how to be a talker.
She knows how to entertain. And that's what I'll give Nene. Nene is good for the show on the value of entertainment.
Mm-hmm. And which is the same thing she says about Kenya. Kenya's good for the show. Mm-hmm. You don't gotta care for somebody for them to be good for the show.
Right.
I don't like Nene's stance on friendship and how she does people and a bunch of her opinions. Mm-hmm. But as she says all the time, it's her opinion, she has the right to like or not. I have the right to not like your opinion or like your opinion. Mm-hmm. That's all I'm saying.
Mm-hmm. This is Nene shit.
So, I mean, it took a while to come on the show. You know, they say that's because she was being punished for putting her hands on that man.
Really?
In the closet. She claims that's not the case.
I don't know.
They say it was a bunch of, like, negotiating deals and stuff. So then when she finally came on, her deal was finally negotiated.
Okay.
You know, they said a bunch of things. Nene say she wasn't let go. She say she walked away. The people say she didn't let go.
Okay.
Whatever y'all say.
I
just go about what I see on the TV.
It's three sides, right?
Okay. Because we don't know these people from Animal Eve. Mary or Joseph. Don't know. So, my thing is, you know, she came on. Mm-hmm. She was on an island by herself. What else can you do when you're on an island by yourself? I agree 100% with us.
With her apologizing?
No, with Kenya. That she's only apologizing because she's on an island by herself.
Well, maybe it'll take the isolation for her to realize that she's been wrong.
And you say apologizing. I ain't heard one.
She didn't say I'm sorry to Eva.
Did she? Maybe. I guess. Because the last time I heard from Nene on the, when was she talking to them all? They were like, I got all these girls in my apology. And she's like, why do I have to say what? She's one of those people who only want to apologize to get it back. That's not a real apology. If you feel you did somebody wrong, but that's part, she don't feel like she did it.
Because she feel like she's owed one in return.
Exactly. I don't like it. I'm not with it.
I don't like it either.
And then even, and you know I don't like Marlo. Can't stand it. Marlo.
Did we give Marlo credit for trying to turn over a new leaf?
No, Marlo is a damn dirty gutter rat in a hole. Can't stand her. She makes me sick. She should have never said what she said about Kenya's mom. And so I would never forgive her for that.
Because you feel like it was too low.
Too low.
Okay.
Especially for that to be someone that you at one point in time considered your friend. Well, and you got mad because she didn't invite you to her birthday dinner.
In that vein, I get you. Because you can't say that, oh, that's your friend. You hit them, like, put the knife there and twist it. And that's too much.
And yeah. Because she didn't invite you to her dinner, but she invited Nene, who you still wasn't good with.
Fine.
Did you forget them?
We didn't know you was the taco season.
Well, that was for, you bought all the chicken in there. Take some of it out. Yeah, that's for, yeah.
No, I just put it, it's all in the bowl. You can serve it. It's just in the bowl.
Well, just throw it in the pan again. Oh,
no, it's fine. It's fine.
You the chef. I'm the sous chef.
I know. It's just the difficulty for your payment.
Oh, my God. I can't. How many times did I pay a cut off on that?
And it's, you know, just trying to get the going. You know. You know, it's just too much. Where
is my drink? I mean,
right here behind you. Let me hand it to you. Here you go. Twizzler stuck to the side. Oh, and then I turned up. I turned this down. We got the. Ooh.
Ooh. I was wondering why I didn't sizzle. I was like, what is sizzling it?
You only did it 3 minutes late?
Sure, I didn't season it.
Okay.
I think I put all the seasons on. I don't forget. It's been a rough night.
Yeah, you do that.
It's
you put this. Put them tacos.
I need another bottle of wine.
Another bottle.
The whole bottle, not another glass. But so, I guess she started her apology tour with Tanya, right?
What's it with Tanya?
Wait, before even the apology, if you mention Marlo, you know, I don't like her. I don't like her.
I feel like Marlo's No, but what did you feel when she showed you that she has her kid, the kids?
I feel nothing for Marlo. I feel anger when I see her on my screen. I feel fakeness when I see her on my screen. Nah, I ain't gonna hate on her. No, she did the right thing taking up for her sister's kids. That was absolutely,
thank you.
That's what you need to do. I would do the same thing for my sister.
Yes, family,
you go, girl. But let me also tell you what I was like. They let Nene get away with that stuff. That scene when she was telling her, like, don't you feel like you gotta own up to what you did with Cynthia too? And she walked out of her on that restaurant.
And went off in on the bike.
On that bike. You got the wrong friend to me. You got the wrong friend to me.
Because then you don't love me to do that to me. Especially on camera.
And that's not your first time. And that's not your first time being this person. And then you played your friend Yvonne. They played us at the grocery store.
Is that a
pawn? They played us at the grocery store.
Come on, let's go. Take it back.
Get it.
Take it back.
We just gonna crumble that and put that in our nachos.
No,
what does
it taste like? I always thought you had to
bake
them.
Nah,
I'm broiled. I eat it. Is it low or
harder? That's right.
Is it right? Mm-hmm. Is it like a nacho?
It's not like a nacho. I ain't just got no salt on it.
Give me that one.
Ooh! Ran too much. But remember when they was at the Marlo's event? And she walked out, I give her credit for walking out because you, although the it didn't have anything to do with you. That was between Kenya and Marlo. But yeah. I get it. You don't want to be in that environment.
You don't want
to
turn up.
But you told it to your spiritual advisor. But here comes your mom. No. What'd you say?
I don't want to get too much into the spiritual advisor, but I'm going to ask you one question. Would you hire her as your spiritual advisor?
That girl? I don't know her.
Nene's spiritual advisor.
But I don't know
her. Based off what you know from the show, would you hire her?
I wouldn't hire any spiritual advisor.
Okay.
So I got out of that.
Life coach?
I look to the Lord myself.
You wouldn't?
I look to the Lord myself. And the brothers in my congregation. Mm-hmm. I ain't going to these little people out.
Mm-hmm. Chinese history.
Absolutely not. Who made you qualify to be somebody's spiritual advisor or a
just one at a time.
Oh, a life coach. Who needs coaching on life?
Some people need guidance.
Give me a therapist.
Some people need. A therapist is to help you sort through your past. A life coach is to help you sort through your future.
So they desperate now. They know my future.
Will they help you build a front? Because your therapist is not even going to talk about, are you having a vision?
Girl.
That's your life coach. The therapist is going to stay and say why you are who you are right now. The life coach is going to help you get to where you want to be. Yeah.
I had a vision of me drinking this at 8:39. It's
8:39? Look at you. That's why people have life coaches.
Okay. Nene has a
spiritual advisor.
I'm on a spiritual journey and I'm still traveling first class.
Is that what it is?
That's what I'm.
No, let's ask him who had the best idea.
Let me check to make sure this camera.
Oh, after all we've been through.
We got PTSD. I look like it's on. I don't feel.
No. Just take it off, put it back on.
It's on. For 10 minutes, 40 seconds. You see, this is my other shows, I always go and check a thing. The one time I'm like, no, it's fine. I ain't got to check it. That's the time it bit me in the butt.
Okay.
So. God damn, Nene. Ooh. Y'all just don't understand what we've really been going through with this technology. But at least
that's
the technology,
because
top flight would got these hands tonight. It's a fugazi.
Fugazi. Okay.
Why do we got one in there?
It's a high end. That's the one you put in there.
And it didn't sizzle. So what's your thoughts on Nene's return and her apology tour? Because I saw with Tanya, and I don't remember them showing an apology with Tanya in a flashback.
She pulled Tanya to the side of
him. No, Tanya had, they went to like lunch or something. And I think that's when Tanya invited her to Canada.
But they only showed a clip of her, of the invitation, right?
Right.
They didn't show the apology or the talk on Nene's side.
No, see, I think they showed the making up. I think they did. I forget.
All I remember seeing was Tanya inviting her because Tanya was like, hey, I invited Nene, and then they showed a flashback.
How about Tanya starting off as Nene's friend, just became Eva's friend, and on this season, she was Portia's friend. I look now, Tanya, unlike
all of me's in Tanya.
Tanya should get a peach, and Eva should be a friend of. Sorry, Eva, I ain't coming for your coin or your bag, as y'all say. I don't make high and fire decisions, I'm just saying what I want.
Yeah, especially just until she gets that stuff worked out with. To me, it seems like it's holding her back a little bit. You know what I mean? But it also could be when Nene betrayed her and went on camera. When she said she was on camera And that would make me hesitant as well.
Nene tears me up. She tears me up with that.
Well, that's her. That's the apology I remember. I don't remember nothing with Tanya. But
I still don't think she gets it. Like, you told this girl, the girl said no cameras, no microphones. You said it yourself before you walk outside.
I'm like, come on, y'all. As much as you stuff has failed us already tonight, come on, stop.
But as you walked through, you said, oh my God, Eva's gonna kill me. So then when she has the attitude, you're sitting up there and someone's like, what did I do to her? What did I do to her?
You know what you did to her.
You know exactly. Because let somebody did that to you, Lanithia.
Oh my goodness.
How you say name? Let somebody did that to Lanithia.
Yeah,
she would have been shooting bricks, okay?
Yep. I'm waiting
for this to sizzle. We just waiting for our steak to sizzle. We got our chicken.
Oh, we can make the nachos.
We can make. Why are we?
Get the plate out of the actually, let's use this.
Cheese and sour cream. Mm-hmm. She got fancy silver. I mean, utensils. Plateware for y'all. She got the fancy stuff. I tell you, we have upgraded with Dishin with Davo.
I'm so glad here.
This is that new stuff.
Now the oven don't start working soon. The stove
don't work. I thought you put the things in the oven already.
I did not. I was waiting for this to beep.
It beat.
Oh, it did? Look, here you go.
It beat. Okay.
Here, put it in.
Okay.
Stop right now.
Oh, this is a full, oh my God, I would be doing this would be too big to put in my husband.
Okay.
Okay. Where are the nachos?
In the closet. In the pantry.
The nachos are in the closet. Come out, nachos.
Come on out,
we're
gonna love you. We're gonna love you.
Come on out, nachos. Don't tell me, I see. We're going the healthy route because our vegetables were not organic. But our blue corn tortilla chips are by Simply Truth Organic. Yes, Simply Truth Organic. You can sponsor us. We will sell your product and make it look delicious. Because these are so healthy. It says organically grown. No preservatives. Best if used by April 13, 2020. That baby you hear crying in the background is the neighbor's baby. We don't have no babies in here.
Aww.
These walls in your apartment are so thin.
Not just my baby. My baby in here. Yourself.
Who is just as cute as Brooklyn baby. But children are no competition. They can both be supermodels.
Right.
They can
both be supermodels.
Are you stabbing the meat?
Yeah, I'm trying to get some holes in it.
Won't it lose the juice?
No.
Who said that? You
said that. I didn't say that.
Who said snake egg? Let's get into it. Let's get into the meat and potatoes of this show. Let's get to Toronto. Wait, Cynthia got engaged before Toronto, right? Yes, she did.
Right before.
Yes, she did.
Okay,
all right.
We haven't talked about two episodes.
Get into it.
So how did the engagement episode start?
She was doing the wine cellar.
No, that's only how the episode started.
Oh, so, I don't know how.
Okay,
but
we can just talk about the engagement.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, can we just get into Kenya and Eva? Their little small little bee. So pathetic, so not worth it. But
it was for miscommunication. I think that's what it was. It was hearsay.
On other people's part.
Right. On other people's part.
Because
Cynthia's the one who said something about energy.
And Portia related to me.
And that's because didn't Cynthia tell Portia, or was Portia standing there?
Portia was there.
So
Portia was there, because Portia asked the question, where your baby's at?
Right,
okay.
And she said, I just don't know how it's gonna turn out. That's true.
And I don't feel like Portia was being messy when she told Kenya. I don't feel like it was being messy.
Absolutely not.
But even if she was, that's what we tune in for the show. I don't wanna see these people get along all the time. I like get along, conflict, but resolution.
Oh, okay, I hear you.
I feel like, and that's probably why I don't like me. I feel like there's no resolution unless you're kissing Nene's.
Well, you see, well, in the next episode we haven't talked about yet, you see what all of that is rooted in. Well, she didn't have my back off. Something that happened last season. And the thing is, maybe it's going to be a deal.
But that's not gonna, we don't know what the next episode is. Remember that mid-season trade?
No, I'm saying, we're talking about the season just before the last.
You, yeah, when she was like, I didn't owe her that. You talking about that yet?
Yeah. Here's the thing. If production has to say, hey, Kenny is coming, technically you would know before the surprise. So you would say to Mike, hey, I have to act like I don't know Kenny's coming. Not because you're a candy product, but because production had to let you know. And that was my whole thing on it. Like, everybody knows how production works behind the scenes.
Let me say this, and y'all, because y'all might not watch. When things pop over, like, because I was like, ooh, no Cynthia did. I got to dig into it.
What's really going on? Is this not
happening? This is not happening. It's hot.
It's
hot.
This fan is a little thick.
Oh,
wait.
Turn that thing up, you. Mm-hmm. So I got. So after the episode aired, Candy has a little. I'm loving you, Candy. Candy has this YouTube show called something. Speak on it. I think it's called.
Is it called Speak on It?
I think so.
I remember her.
Should we see there's some taco meat on it, like sprinkle?
No, that's gonna be nasty. Oh, it's gonna be salty.
And Cynthia said, now I don't know why she said this at the reunion or they just didn't cut it out because they don't want to play production. She said, I don't recall saying that. She was like, I don't want to be one of those people who blame production, but I do not recall saying it. And Candy was like, yeah, I listened to it. I listened closely. Like,
I didn't hear you say nothing.
I didn't hear you say
anything.
Well,
you know what?
Cynthia
said that on this season too, didn't she?
Did you hear that? Yeah. So I don't think she said that. Now, I don't think production did let Cynthia know that. I think it was all a surprise to everybody. Even Candy didn't know until, like she said, until I pulled up. Now, at that point, production should have known that Candy was mic'd up, like she was been doing that audio between Cynthia and
Mike.
You want to put the beans in there?
Yeah, that's hot, right?
You think they cool
they
cool up? Ooh, she tried to take me out on the show.
They in love.
Oh. You
got
to think on it. Mm-hmm. So, I don't think that. What was we at? How I get to that? So you saw my
production
would have also let Nene know, is what you're saying.
No, they would have let Cynthia know.
Right. That oh, and that's why she did whisper that.
We were talking about apologies and why Nene was like, I don't owe her anything to tell her that Yolanda told me that she had audio.
Right. But can we just go to something for a second?
What?
And this is last season, technically. Nene is mad at Cynthia for not telling her that it was a possibility Kenny would show up to the party. Do you remember Nene's wedding? And after her wedding to Greg, her and Kenya got into it because she told because she invited Walter, Kenya's
ex. Oh, wow, yes.
And she told Kenya, when I throw a Nene Leaks event, I'm not thinking about who Kenya is thinking about. I'm worried about being fabulous.
You are right.
So Cynthia couldn't do the same thing, not worrying about who Nene got an issue.
No, cut your peppers up.
My what? Oh, jalapenos. Uh-huh. Get into it. So it's just the hypocrisy of the whole. Now we all are hypocrites at some point in our life. Like it all happens. Like, but Nene, like it's
because
just,
people grow.
It keeps happening. Yeah. And you live and learn. You live and learn. Thank God. Y'all hear that sizzling finally. I've been in this kitchen since
7 o'clock.
She is so mad at that little baby next door. So, that was a big one. Let me just cut one of these off. So I just don't understand Nene's issue with the whole invite thing. Because you're not thinking about other people when you invite somebody to the party.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You certainly knew Kenya and Kim had an issue when you invited Kim to your white party.
Mm. Oh, Smoke certainly did. But actually, I think she knew nobody wanted to see Kim, to be honest.
Right. But you know.
Candy still ain't over
that. And I'm not mad at her for that because she was in a happy place that season.
Yeah, she had that time.
You know, Nene actually had a good season that season, but that's because Kim came on and just said everything wrong. She was a villain to everybody.
Yeah, that reunion was off the chain. Okay, anyway,
this season. So, the Kenya and Eva thing, I'm glad that we made it. Yeah. It was like they didn't even really have to have a conversation. You saw, remember when Kenny was like, I think we just had a silent agreement to just let it go.
Yeah.
So I like that. I like it. Plus, it's easier on Cynthia because Cynthia really loves both of those dudes.
She does.
So that was the one thing. Then what was the other issue before Toronto?
Before Toronto?
Or Shady.
Okay, Eva said every piece of it, every bit of it. And
she got mommy brain though. No, she don't remember.
No, what was the issue last year?
The issue last year was she was going through a wedding.
I think Eva don't want nobody to be able to tell her she what she said and what she didn't say. I think that's what Eva's issue is.
She was going
to the
wedding.
She had said what she said.
And see, I feel like she's definitely going to at the reunion.
Is she
going to
own up?
But I'm surprised she hasn't done it already. Because I think she had love before. I think she had love for Portia. And I think she was really right for Portia. It look good, but give him a little sneak. Get into it. Ow.
That's
ow. Okay. Ow. Get into these jalapenos. So, now how we going to do, because you don't
like jalapenos. Okay.
Okay. Which half do you want to move?
No, put
them
on a little more than half, because I'm going to take a plate to the other side.
Oh, the neighbors.
Yeah, the neighbors.
The neighbors next door. Mm-hmm. Got you. We don't just feed ourselves. We feed others.
Okay.
And no, they're not hungry. Don't come by people.
Oh, please don't. Oh, gosh.
Our neighbors. Don't come by neighbors.
Please don't, because I don't have no cup holder.
She don't. Didn't it? This who sneaks me on how? Could you just imagine your little teeny tiny self against me? I done went out to Kim. I done jumped out to Kim.
Can I put some salt and sour cream in there?
Yeah. so full. Not to be picky or anything. Jesus. Mm-hmm. You think we can get some more cheese on this bad boy?
Yeah,
I love cheese.
Look, I don't want to drown him out, but
drown.
I love cheese.
Give some cheese in there. Put some of this
chicken
on there,
on
okay?
And then we're going to put this on the top. I
good
love
girl.
Cheese.
Get it.
Because I was like, okay, let me not.
Mm-mm, I'm a cheese whiz.
Mm-hmm, look at that. Melt that.
Baby girl is sick. When's she gonna go to bed?
She not.
Did she take that second nap?
No, because I'm not here talking.
Oh, Lord.
Okay.
So the audio came up.
The audio came up.
Now, from the beginning, did you think it was actual audio? Did you question it?
Well, but Nene didn't say she had it, right? Did
right, she said Cynthia talked to somebody, and unfortunately for her, they recorded everything.
They recorded
she said.
The problem. Yes, I believed it. You know why I believed it? Because I thought that Nene would be smart enough to have heard it herself. That's why I believed it.
I definitely thought she would have heard it. But also, like Portia said in Canada, Nene may be a lot of things.
She ain't, no.
Why would she lie about something
lie about
like
that?
This?
She wouldn't, because she wouldn't want to look fooled. Stop that cheese. No, that's good. I can see it wrong.
So, I believed it wholeheartedly.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
That happened. Okay. Why do I look like it's really melting?
Another
30 seconds. Alright, hold on, y'all. We just gonna get a little more to drink. She gonna deliver some food to our neighbors. Challenge me here.
I don't.
What?
I'm sorry, I don't.
I was about to hit her with these vocals. She already know I go to karaoke every Monday.
Every Monday.
Stop this Monday. I'm in LA. I'm in the A.
It is A.
Yeah, the A should have had some karaoke. Well, we could have at least went to the strip club.
I don't
do
no sugar mist.
You're not going to Peaches.
Not showing that.
Okay. You ain't giving him no guac with his nachos.
He has some guac already.
By themselves.
Yeah,
alright. Okay. Give me a plate.
Okay. The cheese look good?
I
know it looks great.
It looks great.
So,
the audio, we thought it was real.
Right. I would have thought, but you know, and that's the thing, like, Nene thought she could try. Did you say well done?
Medium well.
Medium.
Or medium.
I think this is medium, but look at this.
As long as it looks,
Once I went into that some more, I was like, wait a minute, that ain't it.
Okay, and then what was your projection of who the snake was from the beginning?
Your mama.
Me too, because of that scene where she sat down and Marla was like, do you have proof? And she was like, I always got proof, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay.
Also, who is Cynthia around?
It could have been Marla.
I didn't think it was Marlo, because Marlo, I think Marlo would have just said, well, you know, Cynthia said blah, 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 she would have told it. This piece right here is done. I think she would have just told it, you know what I mean?
Your little guacamole on that bad boy. Because I did that thing with this guacamole. Sorry y'all missed out, blame technology.
Okay,
now I'm glad you brought this up, because I have a lot of people in my life, Brittany, who think I don't own up to Kenya when she wrong. Kenya was wrong as a dope. Kenya talks to people wrong a lot of the time.
All kind of way.
You, ooh, she pissed me off that time they was in Houston helping out with them homes, and she did Shamir the way she did, and then Portia was just trying to fix the situation, and she stormed off on, and pulled off from Cynthia.
Pulled off.
Your good friend, Lord, and see, I just got on Nene for doing that with her people. But I say it for all, Kenya was wrong, too.
Yeah, she's wrong.
Now, Kenya did end up apologizing. Did Nene ever apologize to anybody?
She did apologize.
Okay, you're going to stick with Kenya? Uh-huh. Kenya was, and
I think she was going through some stuff.
And I feel like maybe she apologized, too, to Cynthia that day. But even if she did, she also said, like, I ride for her. This is my girl, but y'all are, like, She gives it to me too.
Yeah.
But when she heard the example she gave, Cynthia had every right to say you cannot bring your baby to nothing.
Oh, absolutely.
Let me tell you, Jasmine, if I tell you you can't bring your baby to my home,
you ain't got to worry about me bringing my sister and my nanny. You ain't got to worry about it. Because everything is not for kids.
Everything is not for kids.
And
I certainly am.
If I don't go, that's, you know what I mean?
Oh, it's an issue.
No, it ain't. Because I ain't had no babysitters. It was somebody she couldn't trust.
Scoochie.
Oh, right. It was somebody she couldn't trust. No, but okay. That's the whole reason why Portia had to bring the baby.
Oh, yeah. With that. Mm-hmm. But see, unlike Portia, you have a husband. No shade. We might got to retell them because the camera cut off. The drinking word tonight is shade. Or shady. Whenever you hear those words, have yourself a good drink. I might fill up off of these nachos because I just stuffed this thing with all this stuff going on over here.
I don't have so much guac.
You sure did. Listen. For someone who didn't want to eat on camera.
I'm effing it.
Let me get into this.
Y'all, I did not want to eat on camera. But big girl is hungry. She is boring on the inside of me.
Don't let the little size fool y'all. Mm-mm. Same with me. I'm a fat boy.
Oh my goodness, this food is good.
Baby. Come on, chicken. Come on, Jasmine, with the chicken.
Okay. I thought she was talking like she was choking or something.
Oh, them jalapenos.
Huh? I am.
Ooh.
Ooh, look, he might need something to drink. Today we might need something to drink. I'm going to wait out for this nacho now. This is good.
Show's over. We made the meal that is it, okay? The sauce is not too spicy. She don't like spicy food, y'all. The sauce is not too spicy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. But look, see, I thought you did like spicy. So remember I was like, oh, they ain't have the sauce that I wanted? Mm-hmm. Girl, that thing would have lit you on fire.
I've been out. Yeah. But that's why you already just saw the cream right now.
Can I spill a little of your tea real quick?
What is that?
Yo, we at the grocery store. And she had our neighbor's baby. She made me sneak cheeses behind the baby.
Let me tell you something. That baby's addicted.
She don't want to share her cheeses with the baby.
I don't. And I think everybody out there is going to feel this.
They are.
You don't
want to
share your snack. You don't want to share your snack.
I don't even want to talk about the show no more. I want to eat these nachos. But we got to get to Toronto.
Okay, go ahead.
Because the tacos about, like, all we got to do is the meat and the tacos done, right? Mm-hmm. Once we slab them. Okay. Okay.
No, we're not talking about the engagement.
Oh, that engagement.
Do you think Kenya was wrong?
Say what?
Bitch, you know what? See, I think you're trying me. I think you're really trying to fuck with me.
Do you think Kenya was wrong to suggest to Cynthia that she was going to get a proposal that night?
No, and do you want to know why I don't think she was wrong?
Why?
Because I've been that person with you.
You can tell me that? You thought he was going to get a proposal? On the day he proposed?
No, she got lucky. I mean, unfortunately, it was a dating proposal. But remember your graduation?
And
we was all there. Uh-huh. And I was like, oh my God, everybody's here. I think he's going to propose. I've been that guy when I tell my friends. But But I never thought, like, then I see it, I'm gonna be like, oh, you might be ruining it. But I don't, Kenya wasn't wrong. She wasn't wrong.
Let me say, if she came from a place of malice.
And she did.
She was dead wrong.
Yes, absolutely. And that's what I feel like it's about intent.
But.
Intent.
The only thing is that Candy did suggest to her.
Suggested, but did not know for
hey,
fact.
Hurry up and get here.
I think.
Now, the only thing I would have wished Kenya would have did was ask Candy why. Did he tell you he was going to propose? You know what I mean?
I can get that. But people trying to say she made it about a moment about her. That is, she's not like that with Cynthia.
I don't think she was trying to make that about her.
At all. She was just too excited.
Sometimes your girlfriends be more excited for you than you.
But at the same time, look at Fender. She's like, I don't think so. My mom not even here.
Next up, mom at the
back. Now, I don't know what went through her mind when she saw her mother dig again.
Did she see the mama? That was my question.
I don't think so. But I also feel like, not saying he was wrong, but I think Mike should have told those people close to him.
Well, like I said with, this jumps to Toronto and Portia, give me my own event. Don't sit up here and use another event to propose to me.
Yeah.
I told my husband, I don't want to hear nothing on Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year, Easter.
And I thought your graduation
St. Patrick's Day.
I thought your whole family was there for that graduation. I said, Dad. And you did just like Cynthia. But I'm like, Kenya, I was wrong. Had I been right, I wouldn't have felt like I took your moment. I don't think you would have thought it made it less because you didn't think it was going to happen. Now, had he told me he was going to propose, that would have been some messed up stuff.
I think, oh my gosh, it's really about to happen. I bet.
Okay. I'm going to sit here and eat. Woo! Kenya wasn't wrong, y'all. Kenya, you was right. Well, not right, but you wasn't wrong. You ain't do nothing on purpose, girl. These jalapenos, okay. Burning my mouth. I'm glad she don't like them. I can even offer myself. You know when you eat food and you get happy and you just dance?
The neighbor said we did a great job.
The neighbor loved it.
We are amazing.
We are amazing.
I can get
them
to the head.
But I love what you do there. I love that move.
I like
it. It's not about Beyonce today.
Oh,
except for Beyonce. Because you know every day somebody tells her she looks like Beyonce.
Beyonce!
And I believe in
people need something
violent, really. People just, they think all black people look like. They think you look like Gabriel.
Don't tell
people. Watch Joe Queen and Drinking with Jasmine and Dale. You missed it, you missed a good show because we was on the run. Like J and B, it was J and D on the run.
So, what else we need to cover?
And next thing was Toronto.
Okay.
Toronto.
What about Toronto?
Well, Toronto started off great. So somebody wasn't there. Just saying.
Do you think?
Let me
jump right into it.
Yeah. I tried to be easy.
Production sent. Which time now? Yo mom.
No.
I think so.
I think they would have wanted her there to just keep lighting it up.
No. You know what it was?
Did you call her yo yo?
Because that's what Portia called. That means she never. You shouldn't get full name recognition. I think she said. Yo home. I think they said yo home because remember Kenya was like, security, y'all need to get her out of here.
Kenya is famous for calling security. And but Portia said it too.
But I think it was a thing of like when she was like on Watch What Happens Live, she was like, well, we're not gonna give her, you're not getting no more camera time.
No more.
So either she goes or we go. And I think they was united on that. Even Lakeithia or Lanithia.
No, Lanithia was like, so girl, come on, come on.
Behind the scenes.
But let me tell you another reason why I can't stand them all though. We sitting there devising a plan. Mm-hmm. This is what we gonna do. Mm-hmm. What's the first thing out of her mouth? They're lying. It was never confirmed. I want to be amongst a room of women who speak the truth.
But what's the no? But you know what? I would give her this. What was the next thing out of her mouth?
Yo, I'm gonna go ahead and say. Stand up, Jerry, because but that's what she was in her feelings at this point. Because even the Cynthia didn't curse her ass out. Don't. Woo. And then.
Okay.
Like Nene said, oh, friend. Friend.
This is good.
Friend. Friend.
I didn't. Stop eating nachos. That make a,
I
got
them.
Mm-hmm. Get your
plate.
I don't care if you got to unbutton them hands. You
want to
do it.
Yeah, I'm it. Mm. My plate is a mess, friend.
That's the best part. You suck it up.
You gotta put these in the oven, friend.
Right, but we're gonna eat these. Oh, I got one. I mean, you got one already. Ooh. Okay, so now I can take these off.
So we're gonna eat them at a time.
What time?
Like a time. Eat the one. All right. Well, just put them on there. That's your. Give me. Why is our drinks on a separate side? Uh oh. Excuse me.
This food's sitting in my chest, friend. It's too good.
You sure that's not the baby's milk?
What? I didn't know the baby milk.
No. We all had heads, so. Say in your chest. Baby's milk is in your
chest. That means I'm going to pull up
That's what you were supposed to say. That milk is gone.
It's powder.
Like
they said, powder. It's powder,
friend. Let's wait. Ooh. Watch out that stupid poop poop hole. When Candy, Kenya, and Portia was, what's the word? Not antagonizing. What's the word when you question?
Interrogating. I was dead.
Yo.
I was done.
Like, now we're trying to figure out, you know, who's real, because we don't want any snakes, right?
And
right.
Yes. Yeah.
I know you're the snake.
Oh, she did, though.
I'm going to make a great hand.
She was right. Oh, can you chop these up?
You got the onions all over them.
Yeah, that's what
And then you got the, what other cutting board,
just, I don't know, but you just got the plate.
Just here.
Oh, right here. Cut them on this plate. Here. You don't have no surface area over here.
Do, right?
No, that's gonna flip.
It's not.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Break my bitch. Oh.
First of all,
okay. Look at me. Boop. You have to edit that in. Boop.
The camera will go off again. One more time. Mm. What? I don't know what piece is from what piece. Well, let me see real quick. Let me even see if you made the steak good.
I don't season it. No, I did sprinkle the taco seasoning on it, but that's it.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good
one. I can drink too. Mm-hmm. We got sirloin, y'all. Sirloin. This ain't the right type of snack.
Oh, yeah. No, that's not everything, guys. I know I'm not supposed to use that not for everything. I use everything.
Yeah, everything now. Forget to the show. So. Danny else is, oh. Portia was very mature in how she brought up the situation with Eva. And she was like, normally things go this way because of the show, but I want to do it a different way.
Mm-hmm.
And lolly, lolly, lolly. But I love what she was like. So Candy's a liar. Candy said, I'm definitely not.
And Bravo and them flashbacks.
Wait, because Eva, and like Candy said on something, I think she was on Watch What Happens Live, or maybe it was her YouTube, and she was like, It's so crazy because people do that same thing even day in real life. Like, I'm telling you in front of you and in front of this person, I didn't say it. And she's like, thank God for these flashbacks because it would be no telling because you would really believe that person
going on. Because they bucking up against, because people have learned the power of you against me.
Yeah. That's why I said, that just remind me of people who, like, when they fight, they be yelling out where they from. Because that's supposed to intimidate somebody.
No, but before the fight, I'm from Baltimore.
You ain't to take it back to Israel?
No, I'm thinking about the Tamar.
But we love her.
Big brother. I love her. Shade. But when she was like, I'm from BMO, you don't want nothing.
And that's all I thought about. But that was a good season of Big Brother.
That
baby.
Was a great season. Baby. That was a really great season.
I could have did a different day on that day. But I wasn't doing that then. But it was very mature how poor she is. And I do, people always say Cynthia ain't got no backbone. Even though Cynthia didn't really feel hurt by what Kenya did at the engagement, good for you to speak on your man and address the elephant in the room.
Look, he felt some type of way about that.
He felt some type of way. And I just want to get clarity on to make sure that, because like I said, I don't think Kenya was wrong in that situation, but I understand like where Candy came from, and I understand where Mike was a little upset about that.
It's okay to say she was wrong. And then say that she didn't come from a place of malice.
I still don't say she's wrong.
I think she was wrong because she had to apologize. Do you see the glove, the other mitt?
Did we ever have one?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, let me see this one.
Okay. You know, I cut these in the wrong, but I forgot this is for the tacos. These are supposed to be sliced in.
In light of the fact that Candy said something, I think that was what made it wrong. If Candy didn't say anything,
I thought that too.
If she walked into the event and said it, it wouldn't have been wrong.
Oh, you talking about, I thought you were saying you didn't say. Because I feel like, you know, they just love to hate Candy. I feel like if Candy didn't make a big deal about it, it wouldn't have been a big deal to the people.
Oh, you think so?
That's one of
the things. Well, it would have been a big deal to me. Because I think...
You don't grow with the people, though.
Yeah, no, I don't.
You know, so, you know how to stand the people
are giving Kenny a flack about saying, like, oh, you're this and you're that, and you're... You know what I mean? She did it in intention, in malice, or whatever, but I don't think so.
No. Kenny ain't trying to hurt Cynthia. Cynthia and Kenny really had just one issue, Kenny's first season, and they got past it, and people just won't let it go.
And like Cynthia said, we're sisters, so... When the brother had an issue with what she did, Cynthia was like, look, there's an issue.
Hello.
Okay, now back to Toronto. When Yo-Yo leaned up.
Goddamn Yo-Yo. When she said,
leaned up. And said, something, Portia,
before she said that, she said, foo-foo. Every time she said foo-foo about three times when they got dead on the show. And I'm not a valid, not a deadly valid person. I'm not a fall from grace. Tyler, you gotta stop.
I mean, it was just
We should have did this with Dave about
it. It was wrong. Now the twist.
In somebody's wig?
No.
Oh. Because the wig. The plot twist.
Was all right. I appreciate the plot twist, even though we
just did. Just think of the most dramatical thing, because Tyler said don't spoil it on social media, so we're not going to spoil it. Just think it's a movie from Tyler. You figured it out. You got it.
Shake it up.
Don't overthink it. Don't underthink it. It's from Tyler Perry.
Yeah.
Sorry about the derail matter. Go ahead. Get back into Toronto, because I don't want to be with Grace at. I don't want to be with Grace.
But you was talking. You was the one saying something about when Yo-Yo said
foo-foo.
Uh-huh.
And I got a little dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to go with Grace.
Okay.
Or Shannon. Or Sarah.
Sarah. Okay.
That wasn't that her name?
I don't know if y'all seen Love & Hip Hop.
You know
season
I have.
Season finale. When KK. Not season finale. It's the reunion. When somebody says something about KK's son, and KK.
Poo! Not somebody, it was Poo. Period.
And KK leaned up and did y'all touch somebody? I don't condone violence.
She touched him.
Just touch.
Just a touch.
I don't condone violence. But I will say this. Sometimes you gotta touch people. And Portia, you should have touched yo-yo. No getting up out your seat. No.
Out of nowhere. Y'all talking about the snake? Yo man's a snake.
Just like that.
But she's grown. You say Portia has grown.
Not what you, what's your room number?
You know what's my what's that bitch room? My favorite part. My favorite part.
I'm really full.
That's, we got taco. We ain't made the taco to yet. I'm gonna do a mixture.
I'ma watch it.
This is just Dishin' with Jasimine and Davo.
I just did.
Ain't nobody tell you eat all the avocado guacamole.
Let me know how it is and I'll eat.
It's delicious.
Talking
about the show, girl.
I'm so full.
Now see this steak.
I'm so full. And he gonna cut the steak into chunks.
Some of them is sliced. Look at,
no, look at that big old chunk of steak.
Can't nothing else fit.
That's a burger.
Remember that burger pizza we saw today?
That was nasty.
So gross.
But yeah, I do feel like if Portia would have reached out and touched somebody's hand on that one, she would have been right. All the way right. Because like she said, you're not going to talk about my family.
You know they've been in counseling working it out.
Even if she don't know that, you're not going to talk about my family. You're not going to divert the situation because you're the snake. You're the snake. And let's go ahead and jump to Portia and, Nene and Kenya. And that situation there. Because when Nene got hot,
you shut up.
She had every right because she's backing up her friend. And I'm all for a loyal friend, I'll be friend. Okay.
I don't know her.
You come for my friend.
My best friend.
And you're coming for
my sister.
Me. We are doing it together. I hope you know. People say, oh, that's a game.
I'm missing some.
Oh, is it? Sour cream and
salsa.
And cheese.
Yeah. Cheese.
Just put it down, friend.
Where the cheese go?
It's right here. That's why I'm done. That's why I'm done. Because you won't get me on here looking for cheese.
Yes.
Oh. Ooh. He better go on front of the camera.
Listen.
Oh, guap. I forgot about that.
Get your wine out the way.
I'm sleepy. We need to break. I'm sleepy.
We gotta watch the show.
I'm sleepy.
You got corn on my head.
I'm Cezide.
Zaya from Zaxby's. Zaya. 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 Shout out to Zaxby's. Y'all can sponsor us too. Okay, just ain't going. Just.
That's because you don't put that hamburger helper in there.
Open this up.
Put your plate.
Right there. This ain't a taco.
Put it back.
No. No. No.
There you go.
Okay.
Wait, you need the sour cream.
Oh, yeah. We need the supreme, Taco Supreme. Taco Bell, y'all don't want that, okay?
Okay, look. So, did we finish with the... Oh, that's okay. You might have did that. Did we, listen to
that. So, Nene and Kenya.
Nene and Kenya.
I thought you cut it up in the pan.
No.
You know you wrong.
No, right? Look, pause so we can do a 16 minutes ago.
Flashback. What? I don't know what piece is from what piece. Well, let me see real quick. Let me even see if you made the steak good. This is not bravo. And you gonna keep eating them chips though.
I'm really full.
You gonna keep eating them?
These are already made up.
Yeah, yeah. Fred. Stop.
Oh. The beans.
The oven is on too.
No. Oh. Yeah. No, we got more to make.
What we got? Oh.
I'm fine with
into this show.
Please.
Did you see how Nene told the story to Tanya that Kenya had her finger in her face? She was like, her finger, and it was crooked, and it's like, wait a minute, you pointed the finger first, sweetie. What are you
doing? Does it really matter?
Mm-hmm. It rough.
No, I mean,
well, the finger, I didn't have your first hit.
But both of them pointed the finger.
And I'm pointing your afternoon. So my finger was over here. No, Nene, you had the chance, and you should have spoken when you had the chance to.
You know why I think it don't matter? Because the only thing that my, from my friend that's crying and doesn't have to come out of church and cuss somebody out, I'm pointing fingers, pinky toes, elbows.
You got to get over what I did. What's pointing my finger?
Like, I don't really think it matters. Oh, she pointing her finger at me? Who cares?
Hold on. Because when I tell people apart, I do bring them up. I was saying, Nene was handling herself very well at first.
Oh,
you
not
running back in Kenya, you were calm in the hallway. Your partner was talking.
And for you to know that you was wrong because you know you're wrong.
Yeah. Oh, let's get to that. Let's get to that. How it was no longer a recording. And she told Candy a bunch of times it was never a recording.
It was
an audio. Candy said, well, explain to me because I'm confused with the difference. Mm-hmm. That's what Marlo messed up and starting herself.
No, when Candy said, oh, so you was on somebody's voicemail?
Like Phaedra. Yes. The fact that it came out that Nene never even heard the oil, I was done.
It was ridiculous.
And so was Ken. Ken was like, it's over. This is it. This is it. And poor Cynthia was like, why are you like backing like this? Nene, can you please tell me? You should be like, I don't give a fuck. I said what I said and I had the right to
say. She went back and forth, right?
That's what I felt like.
She went back and forth.
I was like, you had the right to say whatever you said because Nene was dogging you.
I feel like that baby was drinking. Just what
that was. But I, when King said, I ain't never seen you curse somebody out like that. She was giving it to Marlo.
Oh, she, all the way.
She
and
said,
she had
whatever,
a right to.
The right to. Because Marlo always goes, why are you bringing up, talking about she's the most insecure woman? Marlo wants to go low every time. And that little apology the next day, bye Marlo.
But just please don't call me on my name. I said, okay, bitch.
Remember, Shamari did it.
Oh, sure. Shamari. Yeah. What is Shamari?
I liked her.
I did too. And no shade
and
truth, they can use that chat.
Everybody can use the chat.
You right. Everybody
can use the chat. But they do got twins.
College funds to worry about?
Because they're recording. Contract. Not going through. Is that what you're saying?
No. What happened with the recording contract?
Remember they did the little shuttle and they bouncing them shuttles. Bouncing.
I don't know nothing about that. I'm just saying you have kids.
They was on the news. You know everything news. They was bouncing them shuttles. Come on, y'all.
That ain't news.
Come on. They was performing.
That's not news.
It made the news. Made the shade run. Made the headlines. Made all of that.
Shade room news.
All of that. Journalism,
entertainment
baby.
News.
Didn't Portia say she was a journalist working?
But no. Entertainment news is very lucrative. I will say that. That is a form of news.
I ate my tacos, so it's your turn to eat your taco.
Okay, I'm like sick. Because, see,
Don't get sick.
I couldn't stay off the
nachos. Because you gotta do my head. I don't want you throwing up in my head.
I couldn't stay off the nachos.
Girl, you was... that. The bowl was full, y'all. The bowl was full. And now it's full of booze.
That was some good guacamole.
I'm so proud. But you helped me. I don't know if they got it on camera when you did your little.
My Belinda situation?
Secret recipe.
Oh.
Secret recipe. Don't forget those again. I'm going to just do a chicken one. No, I'm going to do like one piece of steak. Why my taco uneven?
Oh, special taco.
Mm.
One was broke and then one uneven.
That's
the
way
it's twin.
Life.
I'm fake. I'm twin. Lord, have mercy.
What'd you just say?
Twin. I had mixed friend and twin, and I said friend or something like that. No, I think I said twin.
I mean, I thought you said something after that.
I'm faded, is what I'm saying.
I
came down onto the
set. So it was something with the F. I thought you said, oh, I'm fake.
Look,
I was like, wait, where did this go?
Look, these are my confessions.
Just that I thought I knew. Why can't you think of something?
fading. After a half that plate of nachos.
Listen, y'all, we're almost done. Because I don't even know we really dish. I feel like we just jump and bounce. But it's okay, because we entertained you. Are you not entertained?
This is not why you're here.
What if they say no?
They we're going to keep fall. Going.
Because it's 9:32. We technically started at 7, but y'all ain't get to see them. It's a camera.
Okay.
Jasmine.
What's our last point?
This mid-season. The fact that we only mid-season.
Oh, mid-season finale, and they still got so much to go. But ooh, I do appreciate
you ain't got nothing to say about Dennis and Portia Tammy last night? Oh, and Tang and Kenya. We got like two more three.
Okay. Portia and I appreciate how Dennis did take time to apologize to the family.
He said what he did, not infidelity.
Infidelity, recognizing that it did not just affect him. I do appreciate that. But you know what? At first, this part made me mad about when he brought up the fact that his number was blocked. But I appreciate his vulnerability.
Mm-hmm. Why did it make you mad? Speak on it. About his number. His number was blocked from who? In case they ain't catch up.
From Portia's sister and Portia's mom's phone. And Portia said, well, I bought PJ, the baby, an iPad, and you could FaceTime her on that. I was upset because it was like not taking ownership for the fact that I don't want to talk to you because you upset my daughter.
And go back to what you said Mama Diane said. What'd she say? She waited all this time for what?
So my daughter wouldn't be a baby mama.
Well, she did wait, yeah, right.
Yeah.
She ain't wait all this time.
I didn't wait all this time for my baby to be a baby mama. So I'm upset with you and I was hurt by what you did. And like I said, I just thought it was a real family moment.
Very.
I thought it was good.
And I'm glad his mom stayed out
in the fridge. Are you looking for the salsa and sour cream?
Yeah.
I thought sour cream was in a little watery. Oh,
not watery.
Because it was out.
But his mama stayed out of it. Like, I felt like she
needed to. Yeah, and what she said, I just didn't know where to jump in. I can understand that too. Mm-hmm. Because technically, my son is the source of your pain.
Right.
And how do I come in? And then also too, like, do you really want to bad mouth your kids?
Mm.
You know what I mean? So it's like, let me just stay out of it. Right. But I'm gonna let him know.
Them out.
I'm gonna let him know every day that he was wrong. So I think it was a sweet moment. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a moment of growth, and mm-hmm. I really appreciated it from all sides. Mm-hmm. Just everybody showing up and being vulnerable.
Tanya trying to be shady coming for Kenya.
Like you said, it was just try.
Kenya bring girlfriends don't do that. Play devil's advocacy and be like.
No.
I feel like I've seen her on the show before.
That's not girlfriends. Mm-hmm. If we're real friends, no. I would never do that.
Well, her and Tanya weren't real. Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I would never say, well, let me play devil's advocate with a table full of people.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And but, I would
again,
tell you,
you're in a group of friends where one, you just kind of know. So you're on a trip with me and my friends, and you heard about
Candace.
That's not
my place. To say,
but you wouldn't want to know whether you should tell them or not, and like put it on an open form so it's not just.
That's not
something
I would tell you.
Don't put me in the middle of it.
Because that's your turn.
Don't you put me
that
in the middle of it.
I don't have no loyalty to her.
But at the end of the day, is it still wrong? Because you
if
never
I
say the name.
But no, if you I'm never girl, if name. I'm girl coding, I would say, hey, look, on a private level, I would say something to you, and then I would have a sit down with us three. Because like you said, I don't know her like that,
mm-hmm.
and these are your friends.
Mm-hmm.
I would have, like, I'm going to say something to her. Let me, I'm going to just tell you what I'm about to say. And then I would tell her, because I feel like that's what you do from person to person. Because I know you, and I don't want you looking foolish. Now, saying I'll play devil's advocate, what's good about the devil?
Oh, but people do all the time. I play devil's advocate, and I hate
about
the
people.
Devil.
Ooh. I'm talking about, you should never play devil's advocate.
No,
an advocate for the devil?
It's just that's the matter. It's just saying, let me say it from the other side.
I take it that serious. If I say I'm gonna give you another perspective on something.
Yeah, that's all I'm saying.
That's not that.
The same thing.
No, it's not. A different perspective on something, it would be like, okay, well, let me show you the other side of a story. Is there really another side of the story if you don't tell the whole story?
My thing is, I'm saying it was a. I feel like she didn't say Tanya's name. And honestly, only Cynthia and them knew because, well, Candy only knew because Cynthia ran her mouth, not Kenya.
If you're the last person to talk at the table when I say, let me play devil's advocate real quick.
And what? You
lost she me. Was the last person to talk at the table. She was like, oh, yes, we're good. We're in love. And then Kenya.
But that's how they edited it. You can't
No, I don't believe that because literally on the last breath of what she said, they didn't.
Because they didn't even show Marlo. They didn't show Marlo, so you never know.
The camera shot didn't move.
Let me say this, because she started it off with the general question. And then...
Let me play devil's advocate.
She started off with the general question. If devil's someone was cheating...
what?
She said it. If you found out someone...
You're saying the devil's advocate is the other side of something, right?
Yeah, because I forgot what they said.
The other side, they was talking about Tanya being in love and not getting married.
I think they were talking about relationships.
No, right before that, because Candy was like, I mean, we're talking about, speaking of getting married,
but they also get married. Right, but they had asked like, Tanya and Portia. So, get off of that. My thing is, she was saying, her first question was, if someone in the group's man was cheating, would you want to know? They all said yes. So I had a friend who was like, that's when you should have told. But then they were like, well, do you have, like, it became more of a, do you have proof? What kind of proof? And as she starts to say it, if you listen in on Tanya, when she mentions like, oh, he just tried to get her number or they exchanged social media, Tanya goes, well, that's not cheating. So that then takes, that negates your original no. I mean, your original yes, let me know. Because I feel like if it would have just stuck at yes, then yeah, Kenya, you should have told her. Once you got deeper into what this actual situation was, where it wasn't an actual
cheating.
So cheated,
you're cool with somebody sitting around you hinting at you?
First of all, this is a show. I'm tuning in for the show. I'm tuning in for stuff like this.
You're saying?
But yeah, you can do that.
Wow.
You can do that.
Wow.
Well, you can do it. And you can have the same approach like Tanya's. It's, you're wrong. We're good. We're happy. It's fine. People talk. People do this all the time. People talk about cheating all the time.
Let me tell you something right now. Don't sit in my face and know my business and then play me by hinting at something that somebody has done. Whether it's a friend, a husband, a child, don't do it, because I'm coming for your jugular. And I'm going to tell you that.
When we cut the cameras off, I got a lot to tell you. A lot to say.
You think I'm playing?
No, I know. Wait, are we done with these though?
They're chips. Are they chips?
They holla bread. Where the oven mitt?
Thank y'all so much.
It's been so...
It's been something. At least they ain't burn. I could use those for the block. My nail broke. I'm trying to bite it off.
So then we have the mid-season finale, which is really juicy. If you haven't seen it, go online and watch it. Thanks for tuning in.
You don't have nothing to tell me because...
Oh, no, that was a total joke.
A nasty review.
It was a total
joke. I don't joke like that.
It was a total joke, and now I found out my friend don't joke like that, so that won't happen again. I have nothing to tell her. Her marriage and everything is great, y'all. But I
and
just,
we fine.
And we are.
Okay.
And... I tune into reality TV for this bullcrap. Like I said, I like drama, but I like, what's the word?
Resolution. After drama.
So hopefully they fix things every union time. Because I like Tanya and I like Kenya. But we not just going to skip over that. Tanya was messy first with that wig thing because her name was never said at that table. I don't care what nobody's. Her name was not said. It could have been any one of those girls. Could have been any one of those. Candy thought it was her at first. Portia thought it was her a second. Marlo had to know it wasn't her because Kenya ain't going to talk about her.
Do you think that Tanya didn't have a clue until Sadie said something?
I don't know, because when they showed her conversation, she was like, she was kind of directing to me. That was after Cynthia had talked
something.
To her. So
and they didn't show that in production.
Yeah, but when they showed it, they made it seem like that they were back in the U.S. Kenya tweeted, she was like, let's stop lying, production.
No. That was the second time they had that conversation. The first time they had the conversation was in Canada, no cameras.
With Cynthia
they came,
and...
Yes, and they came back to Atlanta. That?
Oh, because that's what Kenya said. She says, let's stop playing production. Cynthia had that conversation with Tanya in Toronto.
And they came back to Atlanta. Yeah. So I recognize the location.
Okay. So,
production.
But so, yeah, I mean, before they showed the scene of it, you know, the scene of the cookie lady and stuff like that, I didn't know what she was talking about. I thought she was just putting it out there.
I don't think anybody knew.
And then even Kenya said, like, maybe I'm asking the question because of what I'm going through with my relationship. But.
Well, hurt people.
Kenya, I don't think you were trying to hurt anybody. Kenya really like Tanya.
Hurt people. Nene. Hurt people. Sorry, sad people hurt people.
Let me just say this, Nene. You really just disappoint these season after season after season. Except for when you making money and you got your job. That's when you happy and you nice and all this stuff. And then you just... Oh, well, being friends with you is like walking on eggshells. From what I see. It's what I see. And I really hope great things for you.
Well, I hope she did great things to her and Greg.
I hope Greg don't go what he go through again, because she was just not the, from what I saw, she wasn't the greatest partner, caretaker. And now I get it, it's hard. My mom had to do it. My mom had to do it. Like,
very hard.
It's hard. But when you make everything about you, at least what's on camera. We only speaking on what's on camera. All you women got, we all in life have things to work on with ourselves. We just need to take ownership of when we do wrong. And everything could be okay. Everything can, just as long as you don't go low down to the gutter like that Marlo hood rat nasty scallywag. Had the nerve to call Cynthia bald head scallywag. Marlo, where your edges, girl? Wait, what is
I will say that I feel like if I don't know you like that and you draw first blood on me, it clearly means that you're coming for me.
Hold your blood, who would happen?
No, I'm saying, like when you said, it's up for people who go low down.
Because
I'm one of those people, like, if I don't know you and you said you want to try to come for me, I don't know what your 10 is. But please know you don't know mine.
But even if you know, don't go low down to the gutter. Don't go low down to the gutter. And let somebody come for you.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If somebody come for me, and we don't have no friendship, like you said, it's a difference when you have a friendship and then when somebody just comes for you.
Because I had friends that fallen out with, or they did me wrong, I ain't never do the wrong. I'm still not telling your business.
Yeah, no, you don't do that. You don't just reveal don't secrets and at stuff. All. We were friends, we had a pact, and that was that.
And then you gotta say, we never said a pact to the end or nothing like that.
No, no, but it's a no.
We're not falling out.
We're not falling out. No, look, I just got to stop. I thought about somebody coming for you just now. I'm sorry.
She was ready to go. She's ready to go. Don't play. All right, y'all. It's time for us to go. Food's the bomb. And we're not even lying.
So
we said we were lying.
I know it was so good. I would not have continued to eat. My glass would be empty. That other bottle up there would be done. It would just be, I wouldn't. Yeah, it was really good.
What's your thoughts on the mid-season trailer?
It's a hot mess, Shani.
Nene, I don't care if you say you did or did not spit. Well, you know what you're saying. You might as well have spit on her. So you're saying
you.
So I just have nothing to say. You is just as low as Nancy
Marlowe. Llamas, they spit. Is that you?
You know they call her moose.
I got to be done. Candy and Tall,
that mid-season trailer, I don't like it. Clean it up. Everybody's, what time to say? How dare you? We were rooting for you. We were all rooting for you. Don't you do it.
People go through things.
Don't you do it.
It's unfortunate the camera was there for that moment.
Dennis, your option for talking about a prenup was before you cheated. Now, ain't no prenup. And if it is a prenup, it better say, if you cheat on me, I get everything. I want the whole hot dog factory. And the fries that come with it.
Which means she already got it.
She better. Even stuff Pilar will get it.
Oh, that's true, PJ.
Go, PJ. Get that money, honey. Kenya, may you and Mark, y'all have not filed paperwork. I'm hoping. I love marriage and people being together. Fight forward. It seems like it's just some miscommunication there.
They
no infidelity. She says she wants that, but he won't do it yet. So,
oh, God.
So, work on it.
And if not, can you find you somebody who can ride for you for real? That's it. Who gonna love Brooklyn and you can just move on.
I will love Brooklyn, but I don't want to be a stepdaddy.
Okay. No, we're not ruining your chances here.
Oh, edit that out. Cynthia, may your 10-10-2020 wedding be great and no one ruin that moment and tell you you're probably gonna get married that day. That was just a joke. Continue to find your backbone and keep it going and give these women HE double hockey sticks when they bring it to you. I loved it. That season 7, Cynthia, when her Nene fell out, she was giving it to Phaedra and Nene all of it. And she said, I'm Cynthia Bailey. What else is going on?
Oh, what else?
Something
what else is going on? You're right. That's exactly what she said.
Loved it. Noelle, continue your fluidity.
The
fluids that it entails. Be safe.
Please be safe. Everybody be safe. Go.
Eva. Be safe. Give your peace to take. We ain't talked about Eva since the
What's
first
I say? I'm happy that your daughter has the
Yes, you want to bring up that.
I did. I felt like that was a big moment. I loved that moment. great job, guys, on the adoption and all of that stuff. I pray that it goes through well. And
her husband, Mike, had a tweet for all of y'all saying he not out here to impress y'all because y'all was talking about him at that little cheap old pizza factory. He said he got goals and plans. He ain't thinking about y'all.
And you got to stack that coin up. You got to stack it up. I'm sorry. Like, that's...
Y'all leave that man alone. He making money the legal way. We ain't got another Apollo on our hands.
Fucking no.
Wait, we got to say something to Portia. Or did we already? Okay. Night, y'all. Come on, I don't want to end it. I started this with you. We going to end it together. Thank you for tuning in. Good night. Till next time. She'll be in my little kid. No, I'm moving. Oh, none of y'all. Bye.
This was presented to you by King Davo.